Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_002_DIABM. You can also download this file on the website. Now we need to set up the drawing area. If you look at my drawing area, the present workspace is 3D modeling. Also, there are some settings in this quick access toolbar that you may not see in your own quick access toolbar, but you will understand exactly what is going on in a minute. Now click this arrow to close the chat bar so that you can expand the quick access toolbar. Click this down arrow. Any button that has a check mark before it, it means it's displayed in the quick access toolbar. If you want to bring a button or to the quick access toolbar, all you need to do just place a check mark to that button. For example, if I click a check mark to render, you see the render icon added into the quick access toolbar. If I want to take away the render icon, all I need to do is uncheck the icon, AutoCAD take it back. So this is the way to bring all the to add some command to the default command that comes with the quick access toolbar. Now click this down arrow and place a check mark to all of the command that are in the quick access toolbar except the render command. Click out. Change the workspace. We are going to use a 2D workspace, which is a drafting and annotation. To do that, you can either click the workspace in the quick access toolbar if you have already checked the workspace in the quick access toolbar drop down menu, or you move to the quick access toolbar switches on the status bar and click this button. Now select drafting and annotation. In AutoCAD, you find yourself in a situation when you are in a 3D mode. You want to use a 2D command that is not available on that model, or when you are in the 2D mode, you find yourself in a situation where you want to use a 3D command. But in AutoCAD, whatever command that you want to use, if the command is not available for the moment, you can type the command. We are going to do something to bring some of the 3D command in the 2D environment. To do that, go to the extreme end and right click the empty area and select the show tab button. You see the 3D tools, place a check mark to 3D tools. Right click in the empty area again, show tab, and place a check mark to the visualization tool. This way, if you are in a 2D workspace, then you want to use a 3D tools, all you need to do, go to the ribbon and click the 3D tools tab. This will bring the 3D command. If you want to use the visualization, click the visualization tab. This will bring some command that you cannot find in the 2D workspace. Click the home tab. But if you close the application, then you open it for the next time, AutoCAD restore the drafting and annotation to its default state. To avoid that problem, let's save this workspace. To do that, go to the status bar and click the workspace switches and click the save current as. When you do, AutoCAD bring the save workspace as dialog box. Type the name. I'm going to rename this box my drafting and annotation metric. Click the save button. So whenever we want to use a 2D workspace, instead of we select the drafting and annotation, we are going to select my drafting and annotation metric. Now look at the command prompt. You can type a command in the command prompt. For example, if I type line and press enter, AutoCAD automatically start the line command. I can draw a line, press escape. go to the quick access toolbar and click the undo button. You have series of buttons in the status bar. For example, the display drawing grid, the snap mode, the dynamic inputs, the auto mode, the polar tracking, and so on. Any tool on the status bar has a blue color, it means it's active. Those that has a gray color, it means they are inactive. For example, if I want to get rid of the grid in my drawing, I'm going to click the grid on the status bar. AutoCAD gets rid of the grid on the status bar. Now, if you look at the grid on the status bar, the grid is now gray. You can also use the auxiliary key. If you press F7, AutoCAD brings the grid back. You can also press it to turn it on and off. The auto mode is another button. For example, if I select the line command, I can only draw to non-specific incremental angle. But if I turn the auto mode by clicking it, now I can only draw in 90 degree increment. That way, 0, 90, 180, 270 degree in AutoCAD and more. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the undo button. If you found any command in the status bar that you are not going to use, you need to get rid of that command to get more space and bring a command that you know is useful to you. To do that, click this button and place a check mark to the command that you want to display on the status bar and uncheck a command that you don't want to see on the status bar. I'm going to leave this command as they are for the moment and move into the drawing area. This is a navigation bar. This can help you to move around your drawing, especially when you are in the 3D. In the navigation bar, you have the full navigation wheel. You have the pan. The pan can help you move your drawing into different locations. For example, if I have a rectangle on my drawing, I can use the pan command to move around into my drawing. The zoom command, you can use the zoom command to magnify your drawing in different areas. The orbit command, more useful in a 3D drafting. You have the 3D cube, you have the view cube command. You will learn more about all of this command during the tutorial. Now select the object and hit the delete key. Alright, now that you have a basic understanding of your drawing environment and you have learned how to bring a button on the status bar and take it off, how to type a command on the command line, you need to proceed and start setting a unit in the next tutorial. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along on this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.